held a three-game lead over the Mets with six to play. But those six games included a crucial early October series with New York, in which the Cards needed to win only once to place a virtual lock on the Eastern Division title. On the other hand, the Mets needed to win all three, a tough task considering the Cards hadn't been swept at home all year long. The Mets' task was made even tougher in the first game of the series when the Cards put their pennant hopes into the seemingly unbeatable left hand of John Tudor. Like he had in his September showdown with the Mets, Tudor shut out New York again through six innings. Then in the seventh, with Howard Johnson on third, Mets pitcher Ron Darling missed a squeeze attempt. And when third baseman Terry Pendleton applied the tag, Tudor and the Cards were off the hook. But not for long. After shutting out the Mets through nine innings of a scoreless tie, Tudor could only watch as Jack Clark pinch hit for him and popped up to end a Cardinal threat in the ninth. Then with two out in the tenth, Whitey Herzog could only watch as Mets right fielder Darryl Strawberry sent reliever Ken Daly's pitch deep into the right field seats to give the Mets an exciting 1-0 win. The next night, in a battle of 20-game winners, Joaquin Andujar faced Dwight Good.
You know, they won game one already. Game two tonight. Let's see what the computer has to say about game two. Inspired by their win in game number one of the series, the Mets get going in the second inning of game two. First with a Darryl Strawberry triple, then an RBI single by Danny Heap. It's 1-0 Mets. Things sure look good for New York with Dwight Gooden on the mound as Dr. K strikes out the side in the fourth. But in the fifth, the Cardinals strike back with Andy Van Slyke scoring the equalizer on a one-out double by Terry Pendleton. He later scores on an Ozzie Smith sacrifice fly, and it's 2-1 St. Louis. Make that 3-1 as Tommy Herr blasts his ninth home run of the year off Dwight Gooden in the sixth. Then with the score 4-1 in the eighth, Vince Coleman steals his 111th base of the season, then scores on a Willie McGee sacrifice fly to make the final score of the APBA Major League Players Computer Baseball Game number two of this series, Cardinals 5, Mets 1.
Tonight, once again, the Mets take on the St. Louis Cardinals. And pitching for New York, Dwight Gooden, 23-4, with a league-leading ERA of 1.51. Going for the Cardinals, it's Joaquin Andujar, 21-10, with an ERA of 3.27.
Well, hi, everybody. Andujar in the mound. He has won 20 games his last 2 years. This year, he has a record of 21-10, an earned run average of 3.27. He has worked 261 and two-thirds innings. He has given up 253 hits, walking 81, and striking out 109. Walking under that slider, setting up that fastball inside. Now the sidearm pitch, and it's looped into center field, a base hit. The Mets score and take the lead 1-0 as Carter gets his second RBI against the Cardinals this year. Sam Dwight Gooden on the mound. He has a record of 23-4, 1-1 against the Cardinals this year. He leads the major leagues in earned run average at 1.51. He has worked 267 and two-thirds, and he will be Jack Clark. Hitting 284 for the year with 22 home runs and 87 RBIs. He has been on the Now the runner does go, and the curveball is inside for a ball and no throw by Carter. Well, a stolen base for Tommy Herr.
second hit in 22 at-bats against the Mets this year. And he rips one down the right field line and could be in there for extra bases. Strawberry waits for the carom, and Porter has a double.
Porter entered the game batting only 210, but I don't care what he's hitting, he's always a dangerous out. He has proven that tonight. A triple and now a double. 1983-4 with a 1.51 ERA. There goes Herr. Ground ball up the middle. Backman, what a play! Got him at first! Oh, boy! Had Herr not been running, nobody makes the play.
Well, you talk about the right guy covering. It wouldn't have made any difference. If either guy had been covering, Santana or Backman, they would have gotten this ball, but it was a much tougher play for Backman because he was running so hard the other way. If Santana's covering, it's basically an easy play. And look at Wally get himself squared away and fire.
Incurred some recent arm problems down there also to go along with all the other miseries.
On the inside corner, and we talked about that wide play of Lee Wire before the game started.
Mets have three runs on seven hits. They made one error. The Cardinals one run on five hits and two errors. There's a fly ball hit out the left field. It's deep. It's going. It is gone. Goodbye. Foster with his 334th career home run, and the Mets lead it by a score of 4-1.
The Mets have three players with 20 or more home runs for the first time ever in their history this season. And Foster is 3-for-3 on the night with now. Fastball grounded to Tom Herr at second. He will go to first. And the inning is over. The Mets get a couple of base hits, load the bases, but do not score. So we'll go to the bottom of the ninth inning with New York still leading St. Louis 5-1. Boy, as this series has gone on, you've just been able to see that momentum transfer from the third base dugout to the first base, or rather the pressure, I should say, from that dugout. Usually not for the doctor, however. Ball four, runners at first and second. The middle off Gooden's glove and a base hit to center field. Ozzie Smith will score. It's 5-2 New York.
And the tying run is
presenting the tying run here in the bottom of the ninth inning and a count of two strikes. Ground ball up the middle. Backman and Santana run together and no one can make the play. But the bases are loaded.
Well, it's a routine bouncy ball up the middle. Santana to take it and go to the bag. But Backman is there and they run together. Santana had time to make the play at second on Coleman. But the ball.
Right. Here we go again. Fastball line to Backman and the Mets win it. Tommy Herr hit it right on the nose. But Dwight Gooden survives a ninth inning scare with the bases loaded. And the New York Mets win it 5-2 to pull to within one game of the Cardinals with tomorrow night's series finale yet to come. Gooden wins it to go 24-4 on the year, his 16th complete game. And Joaquin Andujar loses it. He is 21-11. Ralph and I'll be right back to wrap it up. Tim will have an interview for you. Stay with us. Stay with us. 5-2 New York, the final, and we're back after this for Budweiser.
More often than not in 1985, Gooden was better than good. And unfortunately for the Cards, he was in this game also, which ended abruptly when Tommy Herr lined out in the ninth inning.
It's Tommy Herr. But Dwight Gooden gets him to line out to Backman to end the ball game. Gooden wins his 24th game. He's 24-4, his 16th complete game. He had 10 strikeouts. The loser, Andujar, 21-11, 5-2. The Mets win it. The Mets are now just one game back of the Cardinals. The big showdown once again tomorrow in St. Louis. Here's a look at the Mets dugout when the final out was made. And now here's a look at Whitey Herzog in the St. Louis dugout. The Mets win it 5-2.
With their fans solidly behind them, the pressure that was now squarely on the Cardinals didn't seem to affect them at all.
Welcome to Mets Baseball 85, brought to you by Stadium in St. Louis. It's Mets Baseball 85. Tonight, the Mets again take on the St. Louis Cardinals. And pitching for New York tonight, Rick Aguilera, who is 10-6 with an ERA of 3.09. And on the mound for the Cardinals, it's right-hander Danny Cox, 17-9 with an ERA of 2.87.
Well, hi, everybody. I'm Ralph Kiner, along with Tim McCarver and Steve Zabriskie. Control their own destiny. They have to win tonight. Otherwise, if they lose, the Cardinals would have 99 victories. The Mets would have to win their three remaining ball games, and the Cardinals would have to lose their three remaining ball games for the Cubs for the Mets to win.
117 hits, walking 63 and striking out 128 batters. Danny Cox.
And the lineup for the Mets. Here we go. Center fielder Mookie Wilson leading off. Second baseman Wally Backman batting second. Keith Hernandez at first base will hit third. Gary Carter behind the plate batting fourth. Darryl Strawberry in right field, whose home run in Tuesday night.
And the breaking ball lined to left center field. McGee off and running. He can't get to it. It goes by. And he picks it up on the short hop, and the throw in stops Mookie at first base. So the Mets start off with a single.
What a play by McGee, though, to prevent a triple from Mookie Wilson. You've seen infielders make the short hop pickup. A backhanded short hop pickup by McGee. He gets rid of the ball back to second.
And there goes Mookie, and the ball hit right back to the middle. Ozzie Smith is not on the bag at second before the first in time. And because Smith was across the bag and not on it, Mookie called safe at second base, and Whitey Herzog out to argue on the call.
I'll tell you, with the naked eye, it appeared that Smith was off the bag when he made the play. Well, up the middle, that would normally be a base hit, but with Wilson running, Smith's covering.
Ooh. Ooh. Very, very close play, and Whitey Herzog out there to argue.
If they call this play, had Herr thrown the ball to Smith, there would have been no question about it because you can cheat. But when you're catching the ball, a ground ball, you can't cheat nearly as much because the umpire has a better view of it.
What comes off the bag as the catch is made? The question is, was he on? Whitey Herzog said, we lost that one. And the Mets have a runner in scoring position with Keith Hernandez at the plate.
Had Tommy Herr thrown it, you see a lot of shortstops come across the bag there in the neighborhood play, but when you're catching...
Still at two balls and two strikes, just underway here at Busch Memorial Stadium, and the slider hit deep to right field. Going back, the right fielder Van Slyke, it is off the wall. Mookie holding at second base is now being waved in. A play at the plate, and Mookie is in safely. Bad base running by Mookie Wilson, but it didn't cost the Mets anything.
Mookie, the reason he was late coming home is he went back on this ball. This ball, a bullet to right field. Now watch Van Slyke play the carom. A good defensive outfield. Now Wilson was going back to second. Now he's really got to haul it in home. Just beats the throw. That's why you don't hook slide into the catcher. Now, if he had a hook with that left foot, Porter would have spun him right on out of there. As it is, with that straight-on slide, he's able to knock that left foot off the plate.
With 28 home runs and 75 RBIs, and he has missed 7 weeks of the season. And there's a drive to right field. Another base hit, but the run will not score. Carter will be held up at second base, and in front of him, Hernandez held up. Rick Horton, a left-hander, starting to throw as the Mets have scored one on four hits in the inning. One man out, and the batter will be George out of this situation, working from the set position with the bases loaded. And this one grounded slowly out to third, and a great play in the ball by Pendleton, and the force play is pulled off at home. And Pendleton, a magician on that play, coming up with the ball.
That's the reason Terry Pendleton's still in there. Batting only 239 because he can pick it like that. Look at this play. Catch it right next to him. It's what you have to do with those short hops. You got to kind of smother the ball. And on artificial surface, it is easier because the hop's truer. Check it from this angle. Boy, fine play right there.
So the out is made at home, and now two men out. The base. And Danny Cox with his pitch. Slider hit down off the end of the bat, and Pendleton has it. At 71, Rick Aguilera.
And the lineup for the Cardinals, Vince Coleman leading off. Willie McGee, the center fielder, leading the National League in hitting, batting second. Tom Herr, the second baseman, hitting third, followed by Jack Clark.
And if they can win here tonight, they'll keep their destiny in their hand.
Gives you an idea about how young the Mets pitching staff is for the
starting rotation for the New York Mets on his fine pitching with a record of 10-6. And this ball hit off the hands on a base hit up the middle.
Cardinal lineup is you can't defend against him, and he can't really pitch to him that much. They really don't have a lot of weaknesses. He makes a good pitch right here, and look how he fought that ball up. Off. Made a good pitch with the fastball. Now Coleman with a lot of speed on base, and you can't worry about him because it's that guy with the stick in his hand that's going to beat you.
Willie McGee with a record going of 354, leading the National League of hitting. He has 10 home runs, 80 runs batted in. And Coleman draws a soft toss.
Coleman has had problems. See, he was going, and now he stops because he didn't have a good jump. Snap throw, and this was very close at first base. But Coleman's had problems in all three ball games, but he was off to second base on that play.
So because the runner was in motion, they have a runner in scoring position. And the batter will be Jack Clark. Time call as Hal Lanier goes out to check out his base runner. And the fastball hit out to right center field. Mookie Wilson is there. And he made for the Cardinals, Tim McCarver.
Thanks a lot, Ralph. 1-0 Mets lead it with a run in the first inning. And ball well hit to center. Wilson back, way back. He makes a catch on the track. One away. Seven, but he has 69 RBIs. Closed stance. Line to left, base hit. So Pendleton on there, the second hit for the Cardinals, and the batter, Darryl Porter.
The first pitch, and Pendleton hitting the fastball to left for base hit on the first pitch.
Darryl Porter batting 215, but he had a triple and a double in last night's.
And in their ball game in Kansas City, it's Kansas City 2, the Angels nothing.
Curveball gets by Carter. Pendleton may go to third. The throw, safe at third. So
underneath. Carter, now he goes after it. Pendleton, never breaking stride, is on his way to third. The throw is late, and he gets all the way to third base on the ball that was a wild pitch. There he goes, and he just slightly slowed up there. When he saw that he had a chance, he put on the afterburner and got over to third.
This is in seven tries. First and third, one out. 1-0 to Ozzie Smith. Mets lead 1-0.
Ground ball towards second. Backman to Santana, and he can't make the throw to first. Pendleton scores. It's a 1-1 ball game.
One of them was 730. You just can't get the double play against them.
Tonight, the Cubs come here to St. Louis for a three-game set to end the season, possibly. Mets go home. They play tomorrow night at 8 o'clock, and then Saturday afternoon and Sunday afternoon.
And that Saturday afternoon game has been changed from a 1:35 start to a 2:20 start. It'll be Ron Darling pitching for the Mets with a record of 16-5.
Herzog right there, I'll tell you that. Change-up liner didn't work. Hernandez has a base hit to lead off the third.
So Keith up to it as he singles here for a second hit of the game. Off-speed pitch. Keith stays with it, lines it into right field. The Mets' sixth base hit.
Reason I say continuing to antagonize him, Hernandez.
Leadoff man is on, and a ground ball to Ozzie. Backhand stop and throw. Out over to first. Oh, double play.
Or more than a bit sour between those two.
Ground ball towards Smith. It's short. Backhanded play. Play. What a double play turn by the Cardinals. Two out.
Well, the Wizard of Oz at shortstop makes that backhand play. A very good throw to her. And the throw on the first for the double play. They turned four double plays earlier in the game in this series. Now have turned their 164th double play of the year.
Close play at first, but just nipped him. Here comes Ozzie Smith and Jack Clark. Tonight's game to win it 1-0 in 11 innings. High chopper. Ozzie Smith, a tough play. Got him at first. And I'm telling you, beyond description, some of the plays that man makes.
Well, he makes $2 million. And with his glove, he saves an awful lot of runs. And here he gets the speedy Strawberry on a fine play.
No runs a hit, no errors, and none left in the third. After 2.5, it's 1-1. Rip to left. Aguilera came inside to Clark, and he hit a single to left.
Right here, Aguilera throws a fastball inside and down around the knees, and Clark pounds it into right, into left.
Ripped down the right.
Bullet foul, even though it was up.
Ojo on deck as Foster lifts one to left field. Coleman was playing way back, has to come hard, and comes up with a great catch. He got a late break on that ball. But his great speed overcame it.
Late break and a wrong break. See, speed can make up for so many mistakes. That big outfielder's glove, and he turns what should have been a routine play into a scary play from the Cardinals' standpoint. If that ball bounces by him, Ozzie Smith would have been the one that would have had the field.
On the ground and underneath Beckman's glove for a base hit. Strawberry up with the ball as Porter rounds and holds at second.
And he can't be everywhere. Wally Backman cheating for the double play. Ball squibs right under his.
Strikes the count. And he is right back to Aguilera, who goes to first. And the sacrifice, 1-4, moves with runners to second and third. Hits in his last 22 at-bats. One in the ninth inning last night and one in the first inning tonight.
Deliberate. Swing and a base hit to left. Porter scores. Here comes Ozzie. The throw
too late. It's 3-1 Redbirds.
Fastball, base hit, left field. One run is in. Ozzie Smith will score, and the Cardinals lead 3-1. The pitch out is negated, so it's 1-2. And a ground ball in the hole. Backman with a good play and gets him at first base. Fine play by Wally Backman to end the inning. However, the Cardinals score 2 runs on 2 hits to take a 3-1 lead.
Well, Wally Backman doesn't let another one get by him. Boy, what a play by Backman to just get McGee.
Try to keep it.
Mookie running on the play, and a bunt by Backman is a good one. Pendleton to first. In time, Mookie to third, easily on the play. Nobody was covering home, but Mookie unable to get up and take advantage.
And if Backman had been safe, then he got first and third and one out, and a heap of trouble for the Cardinals.
As it is, Mookie's at third with two away for Keith Hernandez, who's 2-for-2. Keith drove in the Mets run in the first inning with a single. Breaking ball, base hit inside the line. Hernandez is 3-for-3, and he'll go to second as Mookie Wilson scores. Hernandez rounds second, but will hold there as Van Slyke finally chases it down. And Keith now with 2 RBIs and a 3-for-3.
Hernandez drives in the big run.
Gary Carter the hitter, and he pokes one into right center field. Van Slyke over and makes the catch. But the Mets pick up 1 run on 2 hits. And here in the middle of the fifth inning, it's now St. Louis 3 and New York 2 checking.
Line drive, base hit to left. So Clark has his second hit. Foster bobbles the ball, and Clark goes to second. So Cox will probably stay away. We'll see. Change up outside, strike 3.
And 3 changeups in this sequence of pitches. That one a very borderline pitch. Strawberry thought it was out of 2.
Hernandez has driven in both runs with a single and a double. Slider, he went too far. Tony Cox.
And after not striking out a batter through the first 5 innings, Cox has come up with those 2 in a row and getting Foster.
Another slider got him. Strikeout number 3 for Danny Cox, who strikes out the side here in the 6th inning. No runs a hit and 1 left. After change up, ripped to right, base hit. Strawberry. Like Ozzie Smith was sitting on some Cardinals.
Yeah, he's right there, right on that.
Won't allow that catcher to come out of there. He's not running, and it may be a balk as Rick Aguilera was called for not stopping. And that's something you see 1,000 times, and all of a sudden an umpire, just to keep a guy honest, will call it. See, Davey Johnson.
Of his guys, we'll look at Aguilera's move again.
Now, he got to stop 1,001.
He didn't come to a set position at the belt.
Curveball tapped towards short. They're not going to get Coleman. No way. If Johnson can't feel that ball, and Howard Johnson made no attempt to go after that ball. I don't think he picked the ball up.
Well, it would have been. been a much easier play for Howard Johnson, but he saw, apparently.
See Howard Johnson breaking right toward third. He never even broke after the ball, and I'm not too sure he could have gotten it. Here it is one time. Now watch the ball being hit. Now see, he makes one little effort, but then breaks back toward third. That's highly unusual.
Swing and a hit to left, and a runner's home. The Cardinals lead four.
Because the third baseman usually takes everything he can get. First and third, two out. Base hit.
McGee had been held in check so far, going 0 for 3 until this at bat, and he just serves one. And what a typical Cardinal inning this is.
Tommy Herr, ball well hit to right center. Mookie Wilson back. He makes the play. Had Wilson not made that play, you could kiss this game goodbye.
And had it been any other ballpark in the National League, it would have been a home run as Mookie Wilson catches it halfway to the wall on the warning track.
Cardinals score one run on three hits. They strand two. They've stranded runners in every inning and lead 4-2 after six. Now here's a word from Busch Beer.
Well, at the beginning of the telecast, you saw the musical feature with Pressure. And the
magic number would go down to two, and it's going to be the left-hander Ken Daly coming in the game.
Well, Danny Cox gets a well-deserved standing ovation. He pitched an outstanding game to this point. Struck out 60. And among the 64 base hits he has allowed, he has given up only two home runs. And, of course, that second home run allowed this year came in the first game of this series in the 11th inning to Darryl Strawberry.
And it is swung on and missed. So Daly picking up a strikeout as he pitches in relief of Danny Cox.
Daly with a fastball. It's high out of the strike zone, but Mookie chases it. He had fouled off a high
action tonight. And it is strike three call. Second strikeout for Daly in relief. Now he'll take on Keith Hernandez.
Well, it was the 11th inning of Tuesday night's game, and boy, that's a borderline call right there.
Pachorik.
That ball looked to be low and away. Pachorik arguing, and it looked like he had a legitimate beef. But Daly struck out the first two hitters he faced in the 11th inning in Tuesday night's game before another left-handed batter, Darryl Strawberry, homered off of him.
And one of those strikeouts when he came in the first game of the series was with Keith. One strike to count to Keith Hernandez. And a fastball, a base hit down the left field line. Dykstra going around the third base. A ball picked up out there by Coleman, and Hernandez with his fourth base hit, and the Mets have the tying run at second base. With two men out, and the batter coming up is Gary Carter.
Hernandez now with two singles and two doubles. He doubled down the right field line his last time up, and now he drives.
And to see a pitching change.
Entering the game to pitch for the Cardinals, number 38, Todd Worrell.
Todd Worrell will be the pitcher. Worrell brought up from the minor leagues and very talented right-hander.
So far, in which he has struck out 15, walked only 7. And yielded two home runs along with a total of 14 base hits.
And Worrell has a fastball that's been clocked at 95 miles an hour. Now the 1-1 delivery. Fastball that's popped up. And the second baseman, Tommy Herr, has it. And the Mets do not score. No runs, a walk, a
two-base hit and two men left in scoring position. And
who flinched a little on that one. Eddie almost comes up with the right hand there.
Now at 2-2, the pitch to Strawberry, hit hard to left center, extra bases. Strawberry on his way to second base, a ball played off the fence, and Strawberry eases into second base with a double. So once again, the Mets have put them 2-2 the count. Fastball, and he struck him out.
Well, they worked George away the first part of it. Now they come to the inside.
And it's lined to left field, a base hit. Strawberry comes in to score. Johnson makes the turn at first base and holds. And the Mets now have the tying run at first base in a ball game that has the Cardinals on top by a score.
Well, Todd Worrell leaves after just two-thirds of an inning. And he did strike out about it. Well, we want to remind
record of 3-2 on the year, an earned run average of 2.99. This is his 48th ball game.
Number 22, Ray.
He has worked 87 and one. And Ray pops it up. Coming on for the ball is Willie McGee, and after a mix-up, McGee tracks it down.
Boy, the Mets out rather nonchalantly, pointing to Willie McGee, who has to come about 9 miles and just did make the catch. McGee sees pointing to Smith, and then he realizes Ozzie's not going to make the play. I've got to do it. And he catches that ball in the webbing. And without his great speed, that ball
first, two men out, top of the eighth inning. And a fastball, strike three. That ends the inning. The Mets get one run.
For Santana at short.
It is just amazing how many balls the Cardinal hitters hit like this. This one turned into an out, but so many go for base hits. Bad swings, topped the ball out, the high bounce off this artificial turf, and the Cardinals take advantage of that artificial turf.
And he is the fourth pitcher used by Whitey Herzog tonight. Popped up and playable in the infield for Tom Herr. One away. In the bullpen, along with Pat Perry. And Christensen pops the first pitch up to short right field. Andy Van Slyke and two away.
And the Mets are down to their last.
Talk about some mixed emotions, Ralph. The crowd cheering and cheering because there are two out in the ninth, and then with Hernandez coming up, about half of them started to boo, and they got caught in between.
Hernandez has not had a home run against the Cardinals this year. Overall, he's had 10.
A blooper, a base hit. Neither Pendleton nor Ozzie Smith could come up with it. And Hernandez is on at first with two out here in the ninth inning.
Well, Keith gets jammed by the fastball. It's a little looping line drive out between third and short. Pendleton couldn't catch it. Smith knocks it down. And the Mets now have the tying run at first with two men out of the ninth inning and Gary Carter coming up. And Carter's going to have to look at a right-hander. 52nd appearance. He has an earned run average of 1.85. He has worked 68 innings, given up 63 hits. Right-hander Jeff Lottie. Carter back in the seventh inning with
numbers to Carter and a swing and a fly ball to short right field. And Slyke is there, and that's a winner! A winner! And the Cardinals beat the Mets. The Cardinals are two games out in front with three to play. What a game.
Ricky Horton pitched an inning and a third, gave up one hit, is responsible for Hernandez, and struck out a batter. Gary Carter, who has 58 RBIs in the last 59 games and was the player of the month in September when he hit 13 home runs and drove in 34. The Mets' number one RBI man against the Cardinals' number one reliever. And the fastball is skied to right field. Van Slyke is there, and the Cardinals win. Three games.